Good morning, guys and dolls. It is a very, very sunny day in the capital this morning. It is gorgeous here. It is currently, well, it's only 9 degrees, but it's really sunny, so it should be nice and warm later. I'm heading to work. I'm going into King's Cross to go and do some lighting, which I'll show you in a second. And you're now watching me on a GoPro Hero 5 Black. Now, to you and me, that means different things, because for me, it means that I've had to shell out about, little as makes any difference, about £1,000 to buy all this recording and stuff and whatnots. To you, it means that you get to look at all the spots on my forehead in high definition. Okay, so I'm now at the wholesaler, taking back everything that I need to take back. We now have to go into Chiswick. Amazing tune, the Pointer Sisters. For anybody who doesn't know what this is, you obviously haven't seen Beverly Hills Cop, because this music was at the beginning of Beverly Hills Cop when Axel Foley, he sat in the back of the stolen cigarette truck, and the police turn up and he tries to bullshit his way out of it, and he was like, "Officer, you won't believe this, man. The truck, it just stopped, man. It just stopped. You got some jump cables, give us a jump." And the cops don't buy it, and then they end up having to make a break for it in this stolen cigarette truck full of illegal cigarettes. And this is the music that was playing. It's fucking brilliant. Absolutely love it. The new super large bit coming through. Just like that. Just like that, he says, just like that. One of the amazing things about this customer is she makes the most amazing coffee. It's just amazing. Papa's got a brand new bag. Job's a good one. Okay, so I've just been installing this pipe for this air conditioning unit here. So just running it down to the air handling unit just down there. And one of the things I noticed while I was here was that the window just above my head has been bricked up. And the reason behind this is quite simple. In the late 1800s, the government introduced what was famously known as window tax. And the idea behind it was that the bigger your house was, the more windows you had, the more tax you paid. And this theory worked well. The problem is a lot of people didn't want to pay the tax. So the way they got around it was by bricking up their windows, as you can see here. I am now back inside, and I would strongly suggest that if anybody is contemplating the option of taking up the career of an electrician at any point, I would sign up for yearly membership with your yoga
your nearest yoga center, because to do this job, you've got to have a very flexible body. And you've also got to have arms like Mr. Tickle. Okay, Father Seamus. It's a very neat job you've done there, lad. Very neat. It's very impressive. Very neat there, lad. It's what a lovely neat job. Don't know what the fuck I'm talking about, but it's a very neat job. I do declare this is a very neat job. I do hope the customer's going to be happy. I think the customer gives a shit about this, because no one's ever going to see this. So I don't know why I'm doing such a neat job. But it's the effort that counts. Okay, there we go. Ah! Ow! Well, I do declare that that is finished. Thank fuck for that.
Right, I'm done for the day. Well, not quite, I've got to go to Putney and it's now 6 o'clock. So I've got to go over Hammersmith Bridge. But I'll do that and go and earn another couple of quid somewhere else.